In today's video, I'm going to be covering the recently released DJI Fly Safe program. I'll walk you step by step through on how to get your authentication application and also how to use the app once you get all that done, along with how to get your LAANC approval, as I believe both of them need to work side by side in order to be completely compliant when you fly your drone in a controlled airspace. Welcome back to DK4 Drones. My name is Dave. Before we get started here, we need to cover a couple things. You need to get your drone out, your controller out, and hook it up, and we need to get the controller serial number along with the device name. And also, I'd like to mention that at the end of this little video, or towards the end of this video, I'm going to go ahead and show you why it's important to have to use the LAANC system here in the States along with the DJI FlySafe app. All right, we'll get started with on how to find your serial number for your controller and your device name. All right, let's open your Fly app, and the three dots on the top right will get you into your menu. Then click on About. And then at the top there is your device name. Scroll down and use the flight control serial number, not the remote control serial number. First, I'm going to show you the geo system DJI has. So go ahead and hit support, click on Fly Safe, and take in this little video. This is a good little video for general information and stuff. Here's your geo systems, and we'll go into the geo zone map, and that'll take you here. Go ahead and type in your city or your town, and this will take a few minutes to load. Okay, so here's your geo zones for where I live. I'm gonna go ahead and scroll that in a little bit, and you can move this map around wherever you want. Now I'm gonna go ahead and bring this down, and you'll see that there's five geo zones and two others. And the five that are most common are the restricted zones, which is this right here, the red, altitude zone, which are these gray ones at the end of the runways, or authorization zones, which are these blue ones. And then you have warning zones. I'll click on that and you can see what that looks like. And then enhanced warning zones. I'll click on both of them. You see there, and it gets pretty busy with both of them on. Then you have the two others, which are regulatory restricted zones and recommended zones. Now I'll go ahead and scroll down, and down here are all the meanings for those geo zones. You can go ahead and pause the video if you want to read through them all, or you can go into the FlySafe program and look at them from there. Now let's get started with the application. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to do is go to the DJI website, hover over the support, and then go over to FlySafe. Click on that, then scroll down, and you have Unlocking Request. Go ahead and take in this tutorial or video. There's a lot of good information in that. I would highly recommend that. And then Unlock a Zone. We'll go in here, and now you have your authentication application. Go ahead and click on that. Now your background certification. You have three accounts to choose from: personal, organization, government, whatever fits you. For me, it's personal. And then I'll go down here, and now you want to hit your country. For me, it'll be US. As soon as we find it here, United States. And then click next. Here you'll put in your last name, first name, email address, and your country's phone code, which ours is 1, area code, and your phone number, type, or industry or type, and they've got all kinds of them in there, energy, construction, IT. I'm just going other, and then I'll submit. Now they're going to want to verify your phone number. They'll send you a SMS code, so we'll go ahead and do that. And it says verification sent. I just received it. And you'll enter your verification code. Okay, and then confirm. And that operation is complete. Here's your background certification and all its information, and you can modify it as well from here. Next, we're going to go into device management. And here we're going to add a new device. And that's why I had you earlier go in and get your controller serial number, because you'll need that here, also your device name. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and add that. I have it copied and I'll paste it here. And device, or the model, aircraft model, is going to be a DJI or Mavic Mini. And then device name is going to be Paul's DJI Mini. And we'll confirm that. That puts that up in here. You can also go in and edit this if you need to, like change the device name or whatever. Okay, confirm that. Now the next one will be pilot management. Here we'll be adding a new pilot. And this will be your DJI account, which will be your email address. And then the pilot's name. Put Paul in there and we'll confirm that. Operation complete. The last tab here is your user feedback. And in here you can give feedback or whatever to if you're having issues with something or whatever. So that's the last tab. Okay, so now we have your background certification, your device manager is in there, your pilot is in there, and of course, again, your feedback. Now we're going to go ahead and see if we can do an unlock request. We're going to hit this new unlock request. It's going to bring up this unlocking request notice. In other words, telling you you're responsible for everything. We're going to zone unlocking. We're going to confirm that. And now we're going to go up here, and this is autofill here. This should all be autofill. Pilot, boom, and then we go next. Okay, we're in the United States. I'm going to put in my town, just because I'm going to show you later on in the video why you need LAANC. Anyway, I'm going to unlock this zone, which is mine in international. Unlock this zone, and I'm going to unlock that zone. So I'm unlocking three zones, which is nice about this one. The old one, you had to go back and unlock each one individually. This one, you can do groups of them. Then I'm going to go today's date, and the reason for unlocking will be recreational, and we'll submit. Let's see what happens. It's operation complete. Submit was successful. And there you go. And now right here is what you unlocked. You hover over this three zones, and it lists your authorization zones, the three that you unlocked. You can click on the view, and it says accepted. Puts all the personal information in there. And also the map with your unlock zones, which you can scroll up on or do whatever you want, move around. And the time range, which is the date. Today through, it gives you 3 days. And then what it's unlocked for. So that takes care of all that. So we're set to go. Now I'll show you how I get my LAANC authorization. I use the Before You Fly app, which is part of Kitty Hawk. Anyway, you'll go in here and you'll go ahead and pin where you're going to fly. And then once you get that pinned, you pull up the menu that has the controlled airspace on it and click on Get LAANC. After it's done loading, here in a second, your flight conditions will pop up for you. Anyway, then you'll go into the map. And you'll pin where you want to fly again. Now you click on that menu and pop it up. Click on Get Authorization. What type of lamps do you want to request, commercial or recreational? For me, it's recreational. Now you map out where you're going to fly in that authorized zone. Now you grab that pin and set it to 200 feet, which is the max you can fly in this zone. Now we set our date, the time, and the duration, how long you're going to fly. Once you get all that, now it'll give you your pre-check results, which is your time and your date and all that good stuff. Here you have to agree and submit. Now it'll show you where your authorization zone is, and you'll also get a text with all that information. And now we come to the most important part of the video, and the reason I believe that in the US, when unlocking your DJI controller to fly or any other brand in controlled airspace, you should use LAANC to get an authorized request. And here are three examples to show why. Example 1. The top screen is a video of the DJI Fly Safe Zone unlocking map that you would use to unlock your controller. The bottom screen is the LAANC map, and as you can see, the max altitude is 200 feet for this location. Next, the top screen is in the same location and is one that I fly quite often. And as you can see, my altitude is set by DJI in this altitude zone at 196 feet because this is an altitude zone and not an authorization zone. Example 2. And now the reason I feel you should definitely use LAANC to get an authorized request when unlocking your DJI controller to fly in a controlled airspace. I'm now in an authorization zone, and the top screen again shows DJI's FlySafe zone unlocking map. And the second one shows the LAANC map, and as you can see, the max altitude here is 100 feet for this location. Now the top screen, which is my controller, shows takeoff permitted in this location. I flew here last year, and what I did was set my max altitude to 100 feet. That way I knew I wouldn't be flying higher than that, or at least make sure you're watching your altitude. And now the third example. As you can see, the top screen is DJI's zone unlocking map, and again, the bottom screen is the LAANC, which shows zero altitude. So you should not be flying in this location per LAANC. Even though DJI will let you unlock your controller in these geo locations. Now the top screen is from my controller that shows takeoff permitted. I did try to start up the drone in this area, and I'm pretty sure I could have flown in this location, even though LAANC is saying zero altitude. DJI did show me a warning of an airport nearby, as you can see in the video, but did not lock my controller to keep me from taking off, like it would if I was in a restricted zone. So if you're in the US and you applied and received a DJI authorization zone or zones license to unlock your controller without using LAANC and think you are compliant when flying in these locations, you may be wrong. My feelings on this? To be safe and within the rules and regulations, we should all use the LAANC system when flying in controlled airspace. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it was helpful to you. And if it was, please hit the like, the subscribe notification, and leave me a comment. If you have anything you need to say or want to say anything, you know, down below in the comments, it's a good place to leave a question or whatever you might have for me. Anyway, as I always say, be safe, fly safe, and have a great day.